Group. Chris, your first thoughts on this bill?
It's unprecedented in size and scope. It's a question of when, not if, it passes. It could pass the Senate before the market closed today. The House likely tomorrow via unanimous consent, which means they don't all have to come back to Washington in the middle of a pandemic. Would flag that this is the third COVID-19-related piece of legislation that the Congress will have passed in 20 days. I mean, it's unprecedented in size, scope, and speed.
Have you seen the text of the bill before I ask you about the details?
No. I mean, no one has seen the final text of the bill. It's probably going to be around 1,000 pages. The overall sticker price is probably close to $2 trillion. But we think what's important to note is with the Federal Reserve leverage on that $500 billion Treasury Exchange Stabilization Fund, you're really talking closer to $7 trillion ballpark.
Is it fair to say that there's not just the $350 billion in direct assistance for small businesses, but that the aid for, quote unquote, Main Street through that Federal Reserve kind of leveraged fund could be running in the trillions of dollars?
Absolutely. I mean, look, you know, we sort of think of it, there are kind of six key areas in this. The first one is, you know, in the neighborhood of $500 billion in cash payments to individuals. Number two, you've got $350 billion in loans to small businesses. Number three, sort of a quarter of a trillion in social safety net enhancements. You've got that $500 billion loan facility at the Treasury. You're going to backstop sort of whatever the Fed does, essentially give them a blank check, because we're all modern monetary theorists now.